So how do you take a design like this from flat and boring to beautifully shaded with color and dimension in Adobe Illustrator? Like anything else in Illustrator, there's actually many ways to do this, but today we're looking at the Freeform Gradient tool. Introduced in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019, Freeform gradients join linear and radial gradients, and they work a bit differently. So if we take a look at our linear gradient here and pull up the gradient panel, you can see that this just has the one axis, pressing G to bring up my annotation tool. And the only thing you can really do with a linear gradient is add color stops and adjust where they blend. With a radial gradient, you get a bit more flexibility because you can adjust where the radial gradient originates inside your shape, and you can manipulate a few more options, but you still just have this one axis to add colors to. With freeform gradients, you've got a lot more flexibility. I'm gonna move this over and just click Edit Gradient to get in here. You can add points anywhere you want on a freeform gradient just by clicking. And if you double click, you can change the color of each stop to whatever you like. You can also change the opacity and the spread of each point. And if you want a tutorial that goes a little bit more into depth on the basics, you can click the link in the description below to get to the blog article version of this tutorial. I want to jump right into my peach example here, which is a little bit more of an advanced example, but really shows off what this tool can do. Opening my gradient tab here, I'll just drag it out because I'll be using it quite a bit. And I've got the colors that I'm going to be using to build my peach across the top here. I'm going to show you a few ways to sample these colors, and our preview is in the corner. So starting with my main peach shape, I'm just going to, in my gradient panel, click on the Freeform Gradient tool. You'll see that it adds a bunch of random points with colors that we didn't really choose. I'm not quite sure how this works, and I haven't seen a great explanation for it, but basically it's giving you random points that depend on what's already in your file, kind of trying to guess what colors might go with your design. That's fine. You can either delete these points by clicking them and hitting the delete key or the backspace key, or you can keep them and just start recoloring from here. I'm going to delete a few because I know that I'll be using my line tool or line mode to add points to this peach. So I'll just put this one point down at the bottom here. And if you grab the eyedropper tool, you can select a color for your starting point. And once you're in this eyedropper mode, you either have to click it again or hit escape to get back out. Now I'll change to lines mode, which is really handy. And if I click on this point again and move my mouse, you'll see you get this rubber band preview. That'll show you where your next point will go. And if you curve them around, this works a lot like the curvature tool for drawing curves, which is great. And I'm just going to add some points around the edge of my peach here, and we'll go back and change the colors afterward. So I'll complete that path. And the nice thing about this is the path is very flexible. If you click one of the points and drag, it will change your path. And if you click on the path itself, it will add a point. Now, if you double click on the color stops, this is where you can change the colors, and you've got three options here. It'll give you the regular color slider menu. You can pick a swatch from your swatches palette, or it'll give you the eyedropper tool, where you can go and pick another color from a design anywhere on your artboard. Super handy. I'll change my bottom point down here to the darkest color. And then as I go along the sides, I'm just going to start experimenting with lighter colors because we're going to start molding the peach into more of a 3D looking aspect. And I'm just double clicking and picking from my swatches palette. You can also sample if you prefer, or I could even go and sample from my already done peach, which would be really handy if you're using a photo reference of any kind. And we'll be layering more lines of color stops inside. So I'll go ahead and apply the colors to this outside ring, speed that up for you, and then come back and show you where we'll put the rest of our lines. Making sure I'm still in lines mode, I'm gonna add a few more lines here, and then we'll go back and color those the same way we did. So I know I want some lighter colors that are gonna follow the top up here, and I wanna be able to color inside the peach, so I'm gonna add another ring. If you're done with a line and you wanna start a new one, you can press escape. And then if you click anywhere that's not on another line, it'll just start building a new line. I'm just going to go around here and add a couple more lines running through the center. I try to picture this as if I had a 3D mesh, which makes it easier for me to visualize where I wanna put my light and dark colors. You don't have to be too careful with where you put your points or your lines because everything can be moved super easily as you're working. So once I have all of the lines that I think I'll need, I'm gonna go ahead and start applying colors to each of these color stops. This process is a little bit like painting, so it's tough to explain. I know where the colors should be because I'm looking at my reference photo, and I highly encourage you to have a reference photo if you're going to do something realistic. This part of the process is definitely where fundamental art skills overlap with the technical skills in Illustrator. If you're interested in more art-leaning tutorials where I can talk about shading and the basics, let me know in the comments, and I'd be happy to make a few videos on that. Now that our main peach is colored, I want to show you how I made this deep shadow effect with the shape behind the stem and how I went about mixing point mode and line mode to color in the peach slice. So this shadow shape that I've drawn is also a freeform gradient. What we want to do here is have the deepest shadow be right next to the stem, and around the edges, I'm going to be applying peach color, but I'll use our opacity setting here to drop that to 0% so that it feathers out into the edges of the peach behind it. So I'll add a few more points around the top, and you can see we start to get this dimensionality with the shadow near the stem. If you click on a point and click to add a new point, it will take the settings from the point that you've just come from. So that's an easy way to copy your settings. And if you're trying to add a point that is too close between two of the points that you already have, you can zoom in, go back to editing your gradient, and now you'll have more room to add a new point. So just a tip there. I'm going to make sure I set all of the opacity around the edges to 0. And that looks pretty good on its own. The other thing I want to do with the shape to really give it a shadow effect is to switch the blend mode to multiply. Now you can see it just deepens the colors behind it and gives you a really natural looking shadow. You can add these things either with point mode or line mode, and you can switch between them quickly as well by just clicking on the points and connecting them. And now you have a line that you can sort of bend around where you want your light and shadow to fall. If you accidentally complete the circuit and don't want to do that, you can just undo Control Z or Command Z on a Mac. And I'm going to turn these colors a bit lighter on the edges. And going back to point mode, I'll just add a couple more here so that I have everything faded out towards the edges. Okay, I think that looks good. So now you can see how you can combine blending modes with opacity settings inside your freeform gradients to get some really advanced shading. If this has been helpful so far, don't forget to leave a like and let me know in the comments below if you're interested in more advanced tutorials like this where we go through a file and break down how it's built with specific tools. I'll go ahead and color the rest of the leaves here, which are just freeform gradients as well, and do the slice, which you'll see is a mix of line mode and point mode. These are interchangeable and you can have as many as you want of both in the same shape, which gives you a ton of flexibility. There's a few extra steps that I did here to really kick up the shadows and dimension in this file. I'll just show you really quickly how I built these few shadow shapes that add the separation between the slice and the peach and the shadow underneath the leaf. So first, taking a closer look at our shadow here between the slice and the peach, this is made up of two shapes. The first is a path that is a solid color with a Gaussian blur applied. If I turn off the blur, you can see the exact shape of the shadow. And with the blur back on, you can see how that feathers everything out nicely. The shape is set to multiply and a 68% opacity, just to give it a bit more softness. Underneath that, we actually have another freeform gradient. If I click Edit Gradient here, you can see the points and colors that I've used. These are set to different opacities around the edges, again, to help feather this out. And going back to the Appearance panel, you can see that this also has a Gaussian blur effect applied. And again, it's at multiply and a lower opacity. Layering these things just really helps with depth and richness of color. And if we take a look at the under the leaf shadow, this is made up of two copies of the same shape. This one just has a single solid color purple fill. It does have blur applied. If I turn that off, you can see that it sharpens up. And again, it's set to multiply, which is one of the best modes if you're trying to build shadows because of the way that it helps the colors blend with anything behind them. If you're interested in taking a closer look at this file, do let me know in the comments and I will do my best to make this available so that you guys can dig around in the file. That can be a great way to figure out how things are built and experiment a little bit. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'm always happy to help. Thanks so much for watching. I've got a lot more tutorials coming, so please subscribe if you'd like to see those. Happy illustrating and have a great day.